Welcome to Red's Game Development Blog. My name is Luca, an indie game developer for the last year and a half. I decided to start making video blogs because I want to update my existing blog with more interesting and advanced methods. And I think this is the best way to go. I hope you enjoy this video, and please excuse my lack of professionality and sometimes my bad English. In the first few episodes, I'll talk about my previous projects, how I started, because about a year and a half ago, I didn't know anything about graphical game program. I only knew C++. So please enjoy my video. This is the first video today. I'll represent my first two projects and something a little extra. So thanks for watching and keep streaming. Yes, I liked it. Welcome again to my video, but this time to my desktop. First, I'd like to represent my blog. It's called Red's Game Dev Blog. And I'm writing it since, I think it's September 2008. Yes, I think that's the date. As you can see, I try to regularly post updates about the games I'm working on, to keep the people who follow my blog up to date. Now, I'd like to talk a little about the start, about my start into game development. I only knew C++ at the start, and one day I discovered Lazy Foo's site, and he has really great tutorials. He taught me everything I kind of know about graphical game programming. He has everything that you need, how to set up your ID, its SDL, and get you going. So if someone is getting into graphical game programming, I recommend this site. After I was kinda good with SDL, I wanted to start going with OpenGL. So I found another great site called Anomalistic Technologies. I think the site is kinda dead for some time, but its introduction tutorials are very good, so check them out. And I've always been interested in indie games, and TeakSource got everything you need. I mean, with the updates about the newest indie stuff, and a great forum where you can ask for help. And yeah, I think indie games are the best games there are. For me, Cave Story is one of the best games ever, alongside Braid. Well, I have to excuse myself. I'm still kind of new to this voice narration, so I think the first few episodes are going to be a little hard for me. So now I'm going to present my first project. It's called Slot Robber. It was the beginning of me getting into graphical game programming. I didn't know anything what's behind graphical game programming, and this is it. Ah, a little too noisy. There's no moving or that because game logic was a big too hard for me at the time, so only pictures and stuff was in there. But I think it's pretty good. You can add coins and just kind of pool to see what you get. Nothing. Again. It's very luck based, so very primitive, but as a first time project, I think it's really good. The graphics were made by a friend of mine, so credits go to him.